Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to solve the problem on this coplanar concurrent force system. So let us see this problem now. So we have four forces which are acting on the hook. So you can see here we have one hook. So there are four forces which are acting on this hook. We have to determine the direction of 150 Newton force such that hook is pulled in the x direction. So here carefully if you observe, so 60 kilonewton, this is acting at an angle of 30 degrees with respect to this 100 newtons. This 100 newtons, it is acting at an angle of 30 degrees with respect to the horizontal. Then next, this 80 newton, it is acting at an angle of 45 degree with respect to the horizontal. So here if you observe, this force 150 newton, they have not given, they have given it as theta. So that is what they have asked. Determine the direction of the force 150 Newton. So 150 Newton force, at what angle it has to be inclined so that the resultant is pulled in the x direction. That means resultant has to be there in the x direction. So from this, what we'll come to know? We'll come to know one condition. That is, if the resultant has to be in the x direction, then summation of f of x will be equal to r. Resultant has to be along x direction. That means all the forces, if you sum up, that resultant has to be there along the x direction. Then next, if the resultant is acting along x direction, its component along y direction will be equal to zero. Its component, if example, if resultant is acting in the x direction, its component along y direction will be equal to zero, right? So based on this, we came to know two conditions. So based on these conditions, let us try to solve this problem. So first, let us take this condition, summation of f of y is equal to zero. That means we will try to resolve these forces along y direction first. So for example, if this is the y axis we have, so let us try to resolve this force 80 kilonewton along y direction. So if you see the arrow, this will be moving downwards. Therefore, this will be, first I will take summation of f of y, that is equal to 0. First let us try to resolve this 80 Newton force, that is minus 80, because that force, it is going to move in the downward direction and we are resolving away from the angle. Therefore, this will be sine of 45 degrees. Then next we will go to the another force, that is 150, we'll take this 60 Newton force. So this is going to move, if you are going to resolve along y direction, this will be moving upwards. Therefore, this will be plus 60. We are going to have, this angle is 30 degrees and with respect to 100, it is 30 degrees. So therefore, total angle is 60 degrees. So therefore, we are resolving away from the angle. Therefore, it is sine of 60 degrees. Then next is, we will try to resolve this 100 Newton force along y direction. So it is going to move upwards, therefore it will be 100. So angle is away from the what we are resolving. So therefore this will be 100 sine of 30 degrees. Then next, the remaining last force, let us try to resolve. So this is what you can say, 150 newtons we have. So this will be equal to, if you resolve vertically, this will be plus 150. So with respect to horizontal, it is theta, and with respect to vertical, it will be sine of theta. So that has to be equated to zero. That has to be equated to zero. So here, if you see in this equation, only theta is unknown. So one equation, one unknown. So we can calculate this. So therefore, this will be equal to 150. If we simplify, we will be getting answer as 150 sine of theta. That will be equal to 45.39. 45.39 we are going to have. Then next, so if you calculate this theta value, theta will be equal to 45 divided by 150, sine inverse of that, or let me write out, that is sine inverse of 45.39 divided by 150. So if you simplify this, we will be getting answer as 17.61 degrees. it. So this is the direction. So we have to apply a force of 150. If you see here, now we have to apply this force of 150 Newton at an angle of 17.61 degrees so that the resultant will be along the x direction. Resultant will be along the x direction, right? That was the question. Then next they had asked us determine the resultant force in the x direction. That means they have asked us now what is the value of R, resultant R. This they have asked us. So what we can do, we can use this another equation, that is summation of f of x is equal to R. So what we can do now, this we can have. Let me use this equation now further. So therefore now summation of f of x is equal to R. Summation of f of x will be equal to R. So let us take all the forces we have, we will resolve all the forces along x direction. So this 80 Newton force, let us try to resolve. So if you resolve, it is going to move towards right. Therefore this will be plus 80. We are resolving along the angle. Therefore this will be cos of 45 degrees. Then next we will resolve this 150 Newton force. If you are going to resolve, it will move towards right. Therefore this will be plus 150. So we are resolving along the angle, that is cos of theta. So theta is 17.61. Then next we will resolve this force 100 Newton along the angle we are resolving. So therefore there this will be 100 cos of 30 degrees. 100 cos of 30 degrees. Then next this remaining 60 Newton force we have, that has to be resolved along horizontally. Therefore this will be plus, as it is going to move towards right side. So therefore this will be 60 cos of 60 degrees. So if you see, this has to be equated to R. So now why this will be equal to R? In the question they have given, the we have to apply the force in such a way that resultant has to move along the x direction. If you see carefully now, here they have given. So we have to apply the force 150 Newton in such a way that hook is pulled in the x direction. That means resultant is along x direction. So therefore now, so that has to be equated to R. So if you simplify this, only one equation, one unknown we have. So therefore if you are going to simplify this equation, we are going to get value of R, that is 316.142 Newtons.